Among the great artists in concert and opera, there are many glamorous names that have won the admiration and applause of the world. But there is perhaps one artist who has held a very particular place, not only in the esteem, but also in the affections of her public. 34 years ago, Ernestine Schumann-Heink made her American debut as Ortrud in Lohengrin. Since that time, her triumphs have extended all over the world. The fullness of her art, the great charm of her personality have never diminished. She has seen her family extend to the third and fourth generation, and her marvelous vitality, her deep sympathy and human understanding have served to strengthen her hold on her public with the years. We would honor her as one of the great personalities of the day, Madame Ernestine Schumann-Heink, artist and woman. And we feel it a privilege to present her to you this evening in an interview by a writer and former newspaper man, now of our NBC announcing staff, William Lundell.
Madame Schumann-Heink, let me congratulate you on this happy anniversary of your 72nd birthday, and assure you that the good wishes of everyone here and of countless thousands of radio listeners and friends come to you tonight. And then, may I ask you, how is it that though you have exceeded the biblical 70 years, you look so well and so strong and so fresh?
Fresh? Good of fresh?
Well, fresh.
Mm-hmm. I think you want to know, Mr. Lundell, the secret of my being well. Why not looking too old?
Yes, that's it. Or rather, I should say you're looking so young.
Uh-huh. Of course, every one of you tries to flatter me a little bit.
Oh, no, Madame Schumann-Heink. Let me assure you that it is most sincere and not flattery.
Well, I don't know. The secret of my being, as I am with all the worries and heartbreaking experiences throughout my whole life, a glorious career, success, honors, medals, titles. Yet I have gone through all the misery in the world. But there is one thing that kept me as I am. My absolute faith in God. And throughout the fight in life, I always knew nobody could do anything to hurt me if not the good God wanted it. He is the judge, master, and the one who leads our lives. I found that this faith in God always helped me in my life.
Even in the hardest trials and losses?
Yes. The hardest experience and the bitterest one was when I lost my 2 sons. But my belief in God that He knows best brought me strength to bear my grief. It was my religion that did it. You see, we Catholics, we don't believe in death. The body dies, but the spirit never dies.
No, Madame Schumann-Heink, but well, they're not silly, fluttering hands with red enameled nails, but they are strong, fine. They're good hands, and they've worked all these years for your children and your grandchildren and your soldier boys and countless others. Those are fine hands, Madame Schumann-Heink.
No. Maybe, yes, maybe no. My sons can tell you different stories. But they have worked my hands, not the boys, I mean the hands. They have worked for my children and my grandchildren and for my lovely soldier boys. They also know how to work. They are disciplined, you know. What causes more misery than anything else? It is too much freedom and too much higher education for the young people of today. We should have the old-fashioned family life, as it used to be and as it should still be.
Do you find that simple home life in many places in your travels in the United States, Madame Schumann-Heink?
Yes. I find the most wonderful family life in the New England states, in Maine, in the small country towns, and in the small towns throughout the Middle West. Not only there, but all over the country, there are still those fine families living. But there is too much freedom in the big cities.
Well, you know, Madame Schumann-Heink, that most parents give their children this wide freedom because they think that by doing so, they will help their children to grow up to be better and stronger in character.
It is not so. Where there is too much freedom, it is not good. They think wrong. A child must be guided, must be disciplined. Yet parents should not be too harsh. A mother's love will find the right way to lead her children. The freedom of today between girls and boys going to high school is a crime. After all, nature is nature, and you can't go against nature. There should be more discipline. Girls and boys should not be allowed to go out in automobiles at night without chaperones.
Well, what would you suggest rather than this apparently uncurbed freedom?
Parents must be respected. The best thing for true national life is good family life and respect for authority. A happy family life means the nation's greatness. The children should be taught to lead a simple, healthy life, and above all, respect for authority. Respect for a father by the children. And if sometimes the father makes a mistake or a slip, the mother should cover it up. The children should not know. The family should be private and all for itself and always strong. Mothers should teach their girls more than what they learn in the high school, not about politics, but to learn to cook, to darn, to laundry, and so on and so forth. Then she will make a good wife and a mother. How can these rich women expect to have the respect of their own servants when they cannot even supervise them?